I'd like to know this. Why are there so many people in this country still equivocating about whether to vote for Obama or McCain? Why are they still equivocating about this subject? Look at these two people. Are they really on some legitimate comparative level? What's wrong with a guy like McCain that you would even consider voting for somebody without any experience? Is he lacking something that you need? Are you disturbed about any of his positions on any major issue? If you ask anybody why they're not voting for McCain, they give you these moronic answers. He's not such a great speaker. Then they tell you, well, he's an older person. So what if he's old? What does he want to play basketball? You're not hiring for a boxing match. You're hiring him to make decisions. You don't have to jump and dance before you make up your mind about an issue. And he is experienced enough with enough issues and enough knowledge so that when he makes a decision, it's based on knowledge and information, experience and wisdom and intelligence. Not like if Obama makes an issue of anything or makes a position on anything, he has to take three guesses like he did about the Georgian issue just now with Russia. First, he said they both to blame. Then he said we have to put a stop to it by asking both of them to stop. And as if Russia and Georgia both committed the same crimes, as if a guy was mugged and you say, well, his fault and his fault are both involved. I don't know who's side I'm on yet. This is such moronic nonsense. A man like McCain, how could you decide not to vote for him? If you have a specific issue, I could understand it. If it disturbs you, if you're for abortion and he's against abortion and that's a major issue to you, I respect that. Everybody's entitled to get what he tries to get, what he wants out of life. But if you haven't got a specific issue that disturbs you, what have you got against McCain? What is it that you want that you think he's not going to do for you? The truth is you don't know. You can't think of anything. Here is a compassionate, concerned man who thinks for himself, and a lot of people want to listen to the fraudulent, phony, disgusting story that he votes for Bush, it'll be an extension of Bush. Would that be an extension of Bush? The most he ever did is talk to Bush. He never was influenced by Bush, and Bush was nauseous from him most of the time that he was president, because no matter what he did, he couldn't influence him to affect him. And he got him nauseous, just like he had all the other Republicans nauseous, because he does his own thing and doesn't care about anybody's opinion. He doesn't blow with the wind like Obama, who tries to take a guess every day about which side the public is on so he could follow it. That's why he changed his mind 32 times in 2 weeks about almost every issue he stood for before. What is it? What is it? If you ask anybody, what is it about McCain that disturbs you from voting for him? They can't give you an intelligent answer that has any substance or significance, because he knows this job better than anybody and has 30 years experience of learning it and more knowledgeable on it than anybody that ever lived. Right now, the surge. If you ask anybody what Obama accomplished, they can't think of anything. But if I tell you that he's the one who made this war a success, when everybody else thought it was going down the drain, when a man like Obama was against even funding the troops, when he told us the war is lost and there's nothing we could do about it, and he left at General Petraeus as a man who's imagining things, this great hero who made this happen, and when now that we won the war, he's so begrudging that he can't even acknowledge that we won the war because he was always against the war, and he can't admit that he's a moron, he doesn't know nothing about it, and he was an idiot in being offended and disturbed by the idea of the surge, by being so defeatist that he's announced the failure before it started, and now he can't admit to himself that we won the war because he doesn't read a paper, doesn't care what the paper says, and somebody would think that he lives in a dungeon in Philadelphia. If you live in the street and you ever saw a paper, you know that we won the war, and it's about time you admitted it, and it takes a sick bastard to keep pretending that we lost because you don't even want to give the troops the pleasure of feeling like they won the great victory. They sacrificed their lives for you and you can't even acknowledge it. And after they won the war, as far as you say, it didn't exist, and if it existed, it meant nothing, and if it meant anything, they accomplished nothing, and the whole thing was a waste of time. That's how you appreciate the people who fought for you. This is how you thank God for the troops who have sacrificed their time and their life for you.
I'm not running for president because I think I'm blessed with such personal greatness that history has anointed me to save our country in its hour of need. My country saved me. My country saved me, and I cannot forget it. And I will fight for her as long as I draw breath, so help me God.
It's not politics he's concerned about. It's your health, your welfare, and your country. And there's no greater patriot, and there's no freer thinker than him. And to be accused of being partners with anybody or following anybody is moronic nonsense. When you heard that speech a couple of days ago, If you heard that speech and you're still not voting for him, I think you should be ashamed of yourself unless you have a specific disturbance about him. But if your only disturbance is he's too short, he talks too low, he's not such a great speaker, I don't know if I trust him. Well, all these problems that anybody has with McCain, you don't have any more problems with your own father or mother than you would have with McCain. His word is law and it's holy. It's never a man who ever went back on anything he ever said and never changed his mind about anything that was in progress that he's committed to. He's committed to something with his life because he cares about it and he doesn't care about the consequences to himself at any time. And if you saw the speech, you couldn't help being moved and touched by his humanity, his compassion, his love not only of his country but of people, and the caring that he showed and expressed for the underdog and to do anything in the world possible to make your life better. And nobody's going to dedicate himself to this as much as he will, because all of his life this is what he wanted to do. And nobody would have greater pleasure in helping you and doing more for you than McCain. He'll lower your taxes and make your life comfortable. And he doesn't have a hidden agenda like Barack Obama, who's going to do nothing for you and changes his mind about what he'll do every day because he has no idea what he'll do because this is not his field. So when you see a man like McCain, thank God you found a great patriot and public servant like him. You should bend down on your knees and say, it happens once in a generation that you meet a man of such self-sacrifice who dedicates his life just to help you, regardless of what it does to him. Do you know anybody else like that? Only your mother is like that. Nobody else.
Fight with me. Fight with me. Fight for what's right for our country. Fight for the ideals and character of a free people. Fight for our children's future. Fight for justice and opportunity for all. Stand up to defend our country from its enemies. Stand up for each other. Stand up and fight.